Paul Pierce is the man. I mean, that three just encapsulates
exactly
everything.
What
about
he
this
is
team.
And what LeBron isn't. And years from now, LeBron will be looked at as one of the greatest players of all time. Paul Pierce, while a great player, will not be in his realm. They'll both be in the Hall of Fame.
Right.
But everybody, 100% of the people, will say LeBron James was the better player. But the difference between the two was never more encapsulated than that. And we have seen over the years from Larry Bird, from Kevin McHale, from Dennis Johnson, from a number of great John Havlicek, to be sure, a number of great and gutsy shots. I'm not sure if that was the gutsiest one, but it is certainly in the conversation. With that kind of start, with as poorly as he was playing, I mean, he was being fitted for the absolute goat horns. He was 5 of 18 when he stares LeBron in the face outside the three-point arc and says, I think it's a good idea that I shoot this three. Now, who at 5 of 18 who couldn't hit the broadside of a barn says, I think this is a good idea. I'm going to take this shot and win the game.
If that were a game of horse, LeBron would have thrown an air ball. He might have, like, missed the backboard from that. Because that shot right there, LeBron's never hit it. He's never hit that shot. And I know Rick Riley could say, it's all unfair of us to pick on LeBron. He's such a wonderful player and a wonderful guy, a sweetheart of a guy, he called him. But LeBron, you want to know, if you're just coming along here in the playoffs and trying to figure this whole thing out, you want to know the difference between Boston and Miami, the difference in Paul Pierce and LeBron James, that shot tells you all you need to know. That shot, Paul Pierce took it with confidence. He loved taking it. His heart rate didn't jump. His palms weren't sweaty. He said, this is what I do. I take these shots. I don't know what my percentage is. I don't know what I've done so far. I don't care. This is what I do. I take these shots. You're right. Larry Bird took those shots. You know, not many. Michael Jordan took those.
Dennis Johnson took those shots.
Kobe. Not as long. Dennis Johnson couldn't hit from there.
No, but critical times in the gut shot.
Way too deep.
I mean critical times.
That
crunch time shots.
Absolutely. Dennis Johnson was clutch as clutch could be, but he wasn't great. You know, Paul Pierce, Larry Bird, they can hit. That is a tough shot. You know, that's just not precious shot. That's a freaking 25-footer.
You said he didn't know his stats up to that point. When that ball left his hand, he had been shooting 27% for the game. 27%!
Means nothing. Well, you know what? The best logic of that was always Dennis Johnson, who said, I'm a 50% shooter. You go, no, you're like 37. He goes, no, there's a 50-50 chance. It either goes in or it doesn't. I have a 50-50 chance. And you go, okay, DJ, you got me there. You're a 50. But that is a... That is in the face of the best defensive player in the game, in my opinion.
How symbolic, huh?
In the face of, and he didn't sit back and let him take it.
Oh, no, he challenged.
He contested it. He's 6'8". He's unbelievably good.
Guards everybody.
Defense. Guards anybody, and he gives you a good effort. He just doesn't have the heart of Paul Pierce. And that shot, when it went in, you know, you just said, you got no chance here, LBJ. You got no chance, Coach Spo. You know, you're up against the force too great. You just don't have what they have.
Did you think you should have drove instead of taking a three?
Should have drove, JT?
Should have drove?
I mean, it was great. I kind of wanted him to drive, honestly. I've been around Paul long enough, and right when he gets into the footwork, he knew he was going to shoot. At least I did, because I've seen him enough. Didn't know if I wanted that shot. Honestly, I thought he was going to drive it, but he made it. That's what players like Paul do. I mean, it really is. He's a big shot maker. He always has been.
Big shot maker.
Mm.
Big. You know what he should have done right there? The Sam Cassell thing. He should have pretended he needed a wheelbarrow to get his gonads back on defense.
Just grabbed them.
Just said, pretend that he needed a wheelbarrow because while LeBron's grapes shrink up to little raisins.
Yeah.
It is swell to watermelons, and it tells you the whole story. It doesn't make any sense that the Celtics are on the brink of eliminating this team. It doesn't make any sense.
Sports Radio WEEI, now on 93.7 FM in Boston.